Yep, what that dude said about the cure and the vaccine, that's so interesting because this has been happening in the real world with COVID. Like, people who thought that COVID was a hoax or, you know, fake or whatever, and then they get sick. And they're like, okay, I want the vaccine now. And the doctors have to tell them, well, it's too late now. You can't get vaccinated when you're sick.
Yeah.
Bloodshot.
Oh my god. Smugglers to the right of the metro. It says keep out. It's got the skulls on the door. I swear to god, why do you have a password if everybody in the kitchen knows the password?
That was amazing. That was so funny. I'm pretty sure that was a new addition, maybe from the mod, or maybe from... Oh.
Do something, man. They're gonna kill him.
Nothing. I checked his pockets. You don't live underground and not have one of Charlie's cards.
Not feeling too good?
Make him take off his shoes.
That great desk
just... Man,
just
sleep down there. They don't give you money unless you're on the council. Take off your shoes. Charlie has no reason to be stingy if he has a currency encoder.
They just hacked a few accounts. They have some extra cash, that's it.
I'm not asking again.
It's just a bunch of us. We go down there to get out of the cold.
All right, we'll back off.
Oh, what the fuck? Okay, I wasn't expecting him to just pull out a shotgun and just execute the dude.
He's dead. My god, he's dead.
What a shame. Okay, you're blocking the...
I can't believe it. He never hurt nobody.
Bro, you're blocking the way. Okay, what can I do? Sorry, bro.
Yes. Password?
Bloodshot.
Our files show that the smuggler is whacked out paranoid. Watch for booby traps. And the latest news? Your brother's team hit some resistance, so they're gonna be delayed while we bring in chopper support.
What do you want?
Why the booby traps? Afraid of something?
Just precautions.
Against what?
Government's been having some kind of crackdown all year. People I know, they've been disappearing.
Is that so?
Think it's a big joke? Lift up a grate in the street. They got my friend Ford Schick in a secret lab next to the sewers.
A lab? In the sewers? Maybe he was taken hostage by the NSF.
These guys are pros. Definitely government funded.
Interesting. Maybe I'll take a look. But I think you should have a little more regard for the United States government.
If you're serious about going down there and finding Ford, I'll give you a deal on some hardware. Also, you'll need this. It's the key that can open the sewer manholes.
Tell me about the hardware.
I have a scope that will fit most handguns and rifles for 2,200 credits, a bioelectric cell for 800, and some light amplification goggles for 3,500.
Too expensive. Maybe I'll try to locate your friend.
We should investigate that. That sounds like an interesting thing. But first, we should go back to the Torn Hotel. Talk to that dude. Wait, where's the entrance? Is over there, right?
Sorry, he's a little worked up. Effective crowd control? What's that supposed to mean? Well, I'm glad they made it.
Why is that guy so baffled by the concept of crowd control? Have we read this? Yep, we read this. Pretty sure I have already hacked this.
I saw your daughter Sandra down the block. She didn't look so good.
Sandra? Was she coming back to the hotel?
I ran off a thug who was harassing her, but she's still mixed up in some pretty nasty business. You'd better talk to her.
No. No more talking. If you see her, tell her I don't care what she's been doing. She can come home. No questions, no speeches.
I'll tell her she can trust you.
I should probably go find her. Oh, I don't know.
The guy's so undecided.
Well, I'm glad they made it.
Yep, so am I. This is the Underworld bar, right?
Buy ambrosia from a drug dealer?
We're talking about your wife, the Grey Death.
I don't know. If I gave it to her, and it was cut...
Jojo's good for it. People know him. He'd be hanging from a streetlight if he was selling bad vaccine. Hey, Shay, Cape Cod. Here's a little vodka this time. Coming up.
Guess I have to do something.
Excuse us, we're having a conversation.
Yes.
Just curious. I thought I heard you say ambrosia.
My wife has the plague.
He already lost his daughter.
Sorry to hear that.
So do I trust some street punk called Jojo to get me pharmaceuticals? Trust him with my wife's life?
I thought ambrosia was an urban legend.
Jojo probably just wants to sound like a player. I shouldn't get my hopes up.
I don't know what to say. You just have to do what you think is right. Can I ask a question?
Go right ahead.
I'm looking around for a power generator, possibly hidden, large enough to power a building.
You in real estate?
I just need to find it.
Of course. You know, I tied in power at a place a few blocks south. A warehouse. Strangest thing. They wanted to conceal these gas-driven generators on the second floor. Didn't give a hoot if their own people got asphyxiated.
How do I get over there?
No way through the blockades now. We went over some rooftops to get there. There was a lift. The code was 3316, I think.
Thanks for the tip.
I think he should do it. His wife is very sick. What can I get you?
You work here. You must know the area. Heard of an old warehouse with an illegal power generator?
Not exactly, but if you're looking for a warehouse, you should probably start in the warehouse district.
Where's that?
A few blocks south. Not a bad walk, but the riot police have blocked the roads because of the NSF.
I'd like to check it out.
Well, you may be out of luck. Even though one of the old warehouses faces onto the park, I don't know how you'd get inside.
Sounds like a good place to start.
Something to drink? Everything in the bar, snacks too, just 10 credits.
That's some heavy augmentation.
Yeah. Ask your netco. What's it to you?
I'm in the business.
Well, I was in an early program, okay? I can still polish a glass. Good luck with your business.
Wow, so this girl is ex-UNATCO. And she still has her mechanical augmentations.
Mind if I ask you a few questions?
Hey, you look like the vigilante type. What if I said I knew where you could load up on military hardware?
You mean that guy smuggler across the street?
Already know him, huh? Too bad. Hey, how about I tell you about something you can't hear from anybody else?
What's that?
Area 51. You heard of it, right?
Actually, I'd rather hear if you know anything about a warehouse with an illicit generator.
I worked out there. Most people think they got aliens from another planet, but I didn't see any flying saucers. You want to hear about it? I'll tell you. For the price of a beer.
Okay.
Shoot.
A beer, please.
Yes, ma'am.
What do you have for me?
You can have this beer.
I appreciate it. Yep, I know for a fact it's not just for government research. I've seen all kinds of executives coming and going.
I'm sure plenty of bureaucrats fly out there.
Billionaires. Big executives. I think the whole place has been taken over by a private corporation.
Not likely.
Something's going on underground. I'm a pilot, which means I didn't get any access to the main complex. But a lot of rock comes out of there. It's some kind of mine. But what I don't understand is why they're always laying more fiber optic cables.
A pilot? What do you fly?
Copters. You know what I think? I think that's where the UN moved Echelon 4 back when they promised they were going to stop spying on people.
Surveillance is a very distributed technology. To centralize in one large facility would be very unusual, even for the UN.
I bet they did it. They want to centralize everything. Every computer on the planet.
Know anything that's worth the price of a beer?
Ah, this old bird's had enough. Hell, I'm about to go on duty.
What kind of chopper pilot starts work at midnight?
You're with UNATCO, right?
Why do you ask?
I'm the one that flies your brother Paul to Hong Kong. He told me to watch out for you.
I didn't know UNATCO hired pilots.
The black choppers are run by the NSA to support various classified operations. Pentagon uses them, the CIA. They hired me because I don't ask any questions.
What was Paul's assignment in Hong Kong?
Like I said, I know how to keep a secret.
So, he's holding something back. The reason UNATCO transferred him back to the States.
Listen to your brother, JC. Respect his experience. Let's leave it at that. Your brother's one of the bravest men I know. I sure hope Paul knows what he's doing. Check out the girl in the leather top.
Okay.
You could at least let your father know you're all right.
He knows where I am.
You mad at him or something?
No, but I don't want him running my life like he runs that cheap hotel.
He doesn't do such a bad job.
He never got nowhere because he never took chances. That ain't me. I'm gonna do things my way.
I think you should be more grateful for what he's done. Let's leave it at that.
Mind your own business.
Hey, miss. Haven't seen you here before. You with the soldiers? You a spook? I don't like that freeloader pilot guy. You're supposed to be buying the ladies' drinks, not the other way around. What a douche move. In the business, huh? I overheard you talking with Shea. I picked you for a spook, but I would have never guessed you were hogged. Well, you carry it better than her, that's for sure.
You'd help Sandra?
I think your friend is going to be all right.
What about Johnny?
I gave him a good scare.
Where's he at?
I don't know, but if he gives you any more trouble, just tell me.
I hope he doesn't think I ratted him out.
What can you tell me about his boss, Jojo?
Oh, Jojo, he's nothing, man. We used to go out. His body mods? Cosmetic. Scars? I saw him cut his face one time just so he'd look mean.
Maybe I'll straighten him out as well.
Well, if you ever want to get into the warehouse where he hides out, I know the code. It's 3316.
Thanks. You've been very helpful.
Jojo shouldn't stick us with guys like Johnny. That ain't cool. Sandra looks a little shaken up. I hope she's all right. I don't know why Sandra doesn't just stay with her dad. He's okay. At least she's got somebody.
By the way, I'm kind of confused. Jojo was handling the ambrosia shipment, but also he's a pimp? Or he employs pimps? It's kind of weird. Used car salesman.
Joe Green, Midnight Sun. Glad to know you. What can you tell me about what's going on out there?
Sorry, regulations prevent me from talking to the press.
Regulations, huh? So you are part of the crackdown.
Like I said, I have nothing to say.
Too stylish for the National Guard? Too athletic for NYPD? You must be from UNATCO.
I really can't be bothered right now. How about I ask you a few questions?
Splendid! I certainly would like to know what an international anti-terrorist organization expects to find in a dive like this.
I don't think I should be asking this kind of question, because, like, I could say, have you heard anything about a power generator, not about a secret NSF power generator. That's a very giveaway thing.
On second thought, I don't need your help.
Then let me ask you a question. What do you think about the summary executions happening on the very streets of New York?
I'd call it civil unrest.
Let me be more pointed. How does it feel to be ordered to murder civilians just because they support the fastest growing political movement in this nation's history?
In a democracy, armed rebellion is criminal, not political.
Rebellion, as the Declaration of Independence tells us, is not only our right, but our duty when we have suffered a long train of abuses and usurpations. This is gonna make a great story.
Okay, I think we've talked to everyone. Am I in the bathroom? Nope. Let's go check the sewers. See if the smuggler was right about his friend.
These tunnels aren't on the New York City sewer maps. Weird. I have no information on what you might be getting into. This seems worth following up.
Aim for the head.
Oh, shit. That's not good. No!
Taking fire here. Taking
fire. Let's hack this. and wake home. Rotate bridge. From security to J. Steward, MJ-12 chemical insertion. Our security grid is now online and active. We will perform a thorough system test every 12 hours to ensure integrity in expectation of the shipment from Hong Kong. If you would like to monitor our status, you can access the grid with the logon MJ-12 and password coup d'etat. What? Okay, this is very suspicious. MJ-12 troop. Okay, so these guys are bullshit. You didn't see me. Okay, let's use two more multi-tools, I guess.
This area is an old water treatment facility. I wonder what all these paramilitary types are doing down here. Considering what the smuggler said, I would imagine this is where they're holding his friend, Forge Schick.
Yeah, wait. I already know the MJ-12. Is that the dude? Yep, that looks like the dude, the hostage, I mean, Ford Schick.
You must be Ford Schick.
Who are you?
Smuggler sent me. Who's holding you here? I don't recognize the uniforms of the soldiers.
I don't know. They're private security for a biotech company or something. They had me doing antibody work.
Corporate security isn't usually outfitted to fight a ground war.
They're doing experiments on people. They don't want anybody finding out.
Wait here while I deal with security.
Tell me when the coast is clear.
Check your six. She could be anywhere.
Let's get out of here!
Make a break for it. I'll protect you.
Here I go!
I don't think... No, I shouldn't have done that. Damn it, I wanted to read the...
thanks. If you see Smuggler, tell him I'm all right. They had me working on immunoglobulin and coatings.
What? Why? This is weird. The plot is weakening. Nanotechnology for stupid people. Feel like a moron because folks slinging around words like universal constructor, grey goo, mechanocarbons, and bucky tubes. Well, no longer. Nanotechnology for stupid people will guide you through the small, small world of tiny machines. Why is this important? Why should you care? Imagine a million microscopic robots, no bigger than a red blood cell, constantly scouring your arteries for plaque and cholesterol. Imagine a supercomputer the size of your thumbnail that can record everything you see and hear. Imagine buildings that assemble themselves overnight. Well, imagine no longer. The future is here, or will be soon, and it's made of little atoms. That's right, atoms. The building blocks of all matter in the universe. Nanotechnology simply pushes the little building blocks around to make new, interesting, exciting things. Even now, scientists worldwide are making huge strides in perfecting the universal constructor that will make a nanotechnological future possible. But already the benefits are being reaped from their research. You'll learn the history, the inside scoop, the buzzwords, and what the future holds, all inside Nanotechnology for Stupid People. Stupid people, when you don't have two neurons to rub together. Check out our other books, including the best-selling Pandemics for Stupid People and Cooking Dog for Stupid People. Okay? Ooh, look. Chlorine and Water Treatment, Report of the New York City Council 2053. On the other hand, opponents claim chlorine compounds can cause cancer, infertility, or birth defects. However, recent research indicates that the increased risk of cancer from chlorinated water is minimal or non-existent. For example, a 2034 toxicological study found no carcinogenic effects at chlorine concentrations 1,000 times higher than the Environmental Protection Agency revised Kyoto standards. And the International Agency for Research on Cancer concluded population studies on cancer rates were too flawed to draw any conclusions. Water chlorination is just one target for some activists. They advocate eliminating some or all of the 15,000 chlorine compounds now in use. This would include most plastics, almost 85% of pharmaceuticals, and 96% of crop protection chemicals. Yet most of the chlorine in the world occurs naturally. The annual global emission of some 1,500 naturally occurring chlorinated organic chemicals totals 5 million tons, compared to human emissions of chlorine compounds of only 26,000 tons. They're talking a lot about chlorination of water. Can't open this. We can't open that. Maybe there's a code somewhere in here. That administration, J. Steward, MJ12 chemical insertion. As requested, access codes have been changed. Your new access code is J. Steward JS1357. Be sure to change the password after you log on. Yeah, we have more things to read. This we have already read. Jacob's Shadow by Andrew Hammond. Chapter 12. A lot of people say this city looks like hell, Ali said. She took a long drag from her cigarette. The glowing tip burned a hole in the darkness. Most people have never been to hell, Jacob said. She looked at him, and he could hear the smile in her voice. And I suppose you have? Jacob said nothing, then stood and walked to the bed. Ali let out a small noise and shrank back against the pillows, as if she'd claw her way into them if she could. He leaned down close to her ear. You like to play games, he whispered. And that's fine, but you don't want to be playing games with me, because I'm the one honest man in this city. You should know that, since we were married. Okay. Interesting. I have Jay Steward. WS from WS to J. Steward, subject our chemist. Your concern about his behavior is unwarranted. However, once the initial trial is completed, you may eliminate him at your own discretion. Okay, so this is the boss talking to the security guy here, telling him to get rid of Ford Schick as soon as the thing that we're having him do would be completed. Interesting. Also, I wonder who WS is. Well, actually, I know who it is, but you know, we're role playing now. Anyway. Operations from operations central to everyone. Subject company picnic. The company picnic has been moved from July 21 to July 28. Please note this on your calendars. Employees on duty or otherwise unavailable will receive a bonus as compensation instead. What? See you there, Harleen Quinzo. Human Resources Director, Operations Central, Harleen. A frown is just a smile turned upside down. What? What is this? Is this some kind of crossover thing? From Security Central to J. Steward, subject system hacking. We've had several attempts to hack into the main Daedalus system, mostly amateur tunneling stunts that don't require a prejudicial response. However, in keeping with standard protocols, all level 1 lock system codes have been changed. The new code is 2167. This will work within the complex, but isn't valid for exterior access. Those systems are on a separate grid, as is the armory. Pass the code on to those with the proper clearances. Archie Rainman, Central Security. Never blame malice for what can adequately be blamed on stupidity. Richard Feynman. WS Delivery. From WS to J. Steward, subject delivery. The main shipment will be arriving shortly, so ensure that all chlorine delivery tests are completed. Your recommendation for the water treatment facilities for insertion has also been approved. Your studies of vector diffusion and initial casualty counts were persuasive. Okay, what are they doing with the chlorine in the water? I wonder. This is a bit weird. Okay. Nothing here. Oh. Okay, I wonder. Okay, there's no other way to get there, so maybe we should, you know what, we should do this. We can't upgrade our skills yet, nope. Not yet. So yeah, let's use the multi-tool. It's okay. We'll find more. Okay. We have... should carry it with us in case we ever have to face I don't know, huge robot or whatever. No! We're supposed to go this way. No? Let's go talk to the smuggler.
Yes. Password?
Bloodshot.
Weird, anyway.
I got your friend out.
Ford, is he all right?
Fine. You were right about those troops. Definitely not NSF.
They're the CIA. They capture people and use them for medical experiments.
I wouldn't go that far. You said you'd make it worth my while.
Since you helped Ford, I'll cut you a deal. I'll give you a scope that will fit most handguns and rifles for 700 credits, a bioelectric cell for 250, or some light amplification goggles for 1125.
Not interested.
Well, you know where to find me. Thanks again for finding Ford.
No problem.
Hey, now that we're friends, Miss Snoop. Your house a bit. The Reluctant Dictators by Travis Crockett. Introduction. Organized at the end of the American Revolution on May 13, 1783, by General George Washington, the Order of the Cincinnati was ostensibly formed as a fraternity to recognize the accomplishments of those officers who had served with distinction during the Revolution. However, the true purpose of the order was the cultivation of a military force ready, willing, and able to accomplish a coup d'etat if the fledgling American democracy began to stumble. Skeptical at the viability of the untried democratic system, Washington took counsel in the story of the Roman general Cincinnatus, Cincinnatus, who was called from retirement to serve as dictator for 16 days in the defense of Rome, after which he returned home to his farm. In the wake of the revolution, the United States was vulnerable to any number of outside forces, and Washington felt that a strong central authority had to be present that could assume control of the government if necessary, and temporarily suspend the Constitution if required. Washington resigned as president after only two terms in office, but remained president of the Order of the Cincinnati till his death. The Order still exists to this day, a shadow organization of the wealthy and powerful that has been linked to any number of other organizations ranging from the Illuminati to the Trilateral Commission. Spooky stuff. The Modern Terrorist's Handbook, Section 7C, Computer Virus Cultivation. One tool or weapon not to be neglected in the arsenal of the modern terrorist is the use of computer viruses to cause disruption to major city services and infrastructure, or other targets of opportunity. Current heuristical viral stalkers are ineffective against modern polymorphic hothouse engines available from many sites on the internet and can be easily linked to IP tunnelers for a cheap, effective denial-of-service attack, or with some programming skills and icebreakers, a mutagenic crash-and-grab bird can be grown for the retrieval of specific info from the unfortunate victims. The following pages will discuss some of the more typical viruses, such as the Bandersnatch V128, Ulysses Dilemma, and 109. Basic firearm safety rules. Number 1. Never point a firearm at anyone or anything you do not intend to shoot. 2. Before handling any firearm, understand its operation. 3. Always have your firearm pointed in a safe direction. 4. Keep your firearm unloaded when not in use. 5. Treat every firearm as if it were loaded. 6. Never pass your firearm to another person until the cylinder or action is open and you visually check that it is unloaded. 7. Place your finger inside the trigger guard only when you are ready to fire. Yep. Funny story. This is... it's not really a funny story, but you know. Funny story. This is where I learned gun safety from as a kid. I take your chocolate. Yeah, this is where I learned that all guns are always loaded. That's the best thing to remember about guns. And of course, never point the gun to anything you don't want shot. Okay, so I guess it's time to move on to the warehouse district. The people we spoke to directed us toward... directed us to go to Osgood & Sons. Right?
This. Take it from here.
Osgood & Sons Imports. Okay. Can we... Commander Fraze, UNATCO has regrouped more quickly than expected and is beginning a coordinated assault on our position along with local police. They will certainly overrun our defenses eventually, but they must be delayed until the next phase of the mission can be completed. Your men will be responsible for guarding the tunnels leading to the generation station. Dig in and arm all available automatic defenses. I don't need to tell you what's at stake. Good luck. JL. Is JL Juan Lebedev? We learned about him from this. Contacts in frequent contact with Jojo Fine, Juan Ivanovich Lebedev, and other sympathizers. JL. Maybe that's him, but we can't be sure. Okay. We should blow this up. Hopefully this will work.
I don't think we should hold back in a situation like this.
Oh. Okay, let's see if this works. Oh. Oh. Okay, it worked.
We'll have to get the city out here to clean up the mess.
Yep. Four tools. Can we now maybe... Nope, we still can't raise our electronic skills. I would have liked to open this door. But I don't think we know of any code, right? Yeah, we don't. Warehouse code 3316, maybe this? Nope. Oh. Wait, we just got some points. Maybe we can improve our electronics skills. By studying electronics and its practical application, agents can more efficiently bypass a number of security systems using multi-tools. Okay. Okay, now it needs two tools. Two is something we can deal with. Whoa, yep, this was worth it, definitely.